Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to download an ebook in PDF format from Google eBooks. So first of all, what I need to do, I'll need to open Google eBooks on my computer. I'll share all the links in the description. So what I'll do, I'll open the first link, that is Google eBooks. So I'll copy this, minimize and paste this. So after I open this, I'll go to my books. So here you can see different books that I have already saved or purchased into my library. So what I'll do, I'll open my Android app and download a new book. So suppose I'll download a new book. So I have added a book to my library using my Android app. So I'll refresh this page. So this is the book that I have added. So I'll go back to Google Books. I'll pick these three options. Export ASCM for PDF. After I export this, it will download me an ASCM file. This file is what I got after downloading it. So you can also use the export ASCM for EPUB if you want an EPUB file. But this time I'm going to show you only for the PDF. So after this, we need to download Adobe Digital Editions. So what I'll do, I'll go to the Adobe Digital Editions page. So this is the download page for Adobe Digital Editions. You can download for a MacBook or for your Windows PC. I have already downloaded and installed on my Windows PC. So on my PC, I'll open Adobe Digital Editions. So after it opens, I'll go to File, Add to Library. I'll open that, go here options and select Adobe Content Service Message. So after this, I'll add this Calm the Hectic Mind that I have downloaded right now and click open. It will ask me for authorization. I'll click here. I want to authorize without an ID and then click next. And then after that, authorize. Once it's authorized, you will see your book added. So it's not showing, let it wait for some time. So it's downloading my PDF. Depending on the size of your file, it may take a while for downloading this file. So this is the file that I have downloaded. So if I go back, right click on it and check item info and click this arrow, it will get me to the downloaded file. But if I open it, it won't, because it is digitally locked. And we need to remove the lock. In order to remove this lock, we need to download another file that's called Adobe eBook Converter. So I'll copy its link and go to the URL. After this, I'll download either this one or this one depending on my operating system type. To make things easier, I have already downloaded and installed it, and it's here, any ebook converter. So this is a trial mode, but it would do the job for us. So I'll click OK and then click this files option. After this, we'll click Adobe DE. So this is the file I downloaded right now. So we'll double click it. So it's removing the lock. So the file is now decrypted. I'll right click it, explore decrypted file. I'll copy this file, because if I close the software, this file will also get deleted. I'll go to my desktop and paste the same file. So I'll open this and you can see that the file has been downloaded. Now still the problem remains that I cannot copy anything from this file. To solve this, we'll just print this file and send it to OneNote. So in Office 2019, you do not have OneNote. Before that, every Office version has a OneNote. So I'll go to print to OneNote and start printing this file. So it's opening my OneNote and it's asking me where I want to insert my printout. So I'll just click this plus option and click printout, or anywhere I can insert this printout, and click OK. So it's inserting this file. So again, I can't copy anything from here. So what I'll do, I'll right click, make image in text and image searchable, click English, right click again, copy text from all pages of the printout. So after this, I'll open my Word document. Create a new document. And paste whatever was copied. So if I bring it to the right side and this one to the left side, I can verify whether everything has been copied. So this is the 6 mental issues for busy people to calm their minds. So this is what was the first page. Then I'll have the copyright page like this. Then the contents page. So you can see that the contents of this file PDF have been copied to the Word file. And then you can copy paste or use it in what way you want. So this is all that you need to do. Also, if you have any queries, you can text me on Telegram or post it in the comments below. Thank you.